Dilemma. My wedding dilemma. Anoop Shahab.
Do you guys know what is the favorite pastime of Indian parents? Any guesses?
Marry off their children.
Yes. And it doesn't stop there. They want grandchildren. My fellow Toastmasters and dear guests, Indian weddings are fun. This is what happened over the weekend. I was talking to my mother and we were talking about normal stuff. Food, life, health. And suddenly she realizes that her charming and very handsome son is turning 30. By the way, that's me. In India, if you turn 30, it doesn't mean that you just age. You become unmarriageable. She asked me to send her my bio data. And I was, what is that? So she explains the first step in finding a bride. Before you apply to the beautiful heartthrobs of Indian marriageable women, you have to prepare a wedding resume. It must enlist your height, weight, skin color, a dashing photograph, and a six-figure salary. It doesn't matter if you don't have a six-figure salary, you can adjust the zeros in the end. Because we all know that all the things on your resume are not true. I'm like, I'm just 28 years young. I don't want to get married that early. But Indian moms, they never stop. They know what you like, what you do, and they can always catch a grasp of you at any question. She throws me a simple question. What did you do over the last weekend? I said, I guess it was a sunny day. I woke up late, had a brunch, and then spent my day in the bed watching movies. And I got backlashed immediately. She says, aren't you living in the state of mountains? Aren't you supposed to hike? Go out and bathe in the sunshine. I was stupid to say my friends were busy. And there she was. She says, see, if you get married, you don't need friends. You can take your wife anywhere. She will go to movies, shopping, hiking, anything you say. I'm still not sure. She says, she'll be your companion. She'll cook food for you. And I'm like, I do cook food and I do cook good food. She says, like, every day. And as the previous members know that food is the most important part of my life, I barge in. I say, okay, there is no harm in giving it a try. So there comes the second step. She says, take good pictures of yourself. Update your Instagram, Facebook, and LinkedIn. Because the girl and her father are going to be the detectives. And they want to know all your social activities. So keep them updated. The third step. You have to lose weight. I have lost enough, but I still have to lose weight. Be good looking, smart, and sexy. I don't know what is with that. But what matters the most is this figure. Not this figure, the figures in your salary. The higher the number, the higher the proposals. It makes you the best candidate in the wedding market. Last but not the least, and it is before many other marriage steps, your marketing. And who is your marketing team? Do you know any guesses?
Your mother.
No. Your whole clan of relatives. You know, it's not only your parents' hobby to get you married. The relatives, it's their passion to get your pleasures of singlehood get screwed. You know, no matter where you are, they'll always find you. And they will always ask you the same question. When are you getting married? You can't run away. This question has scared the hell out of all the youngsters in India. Because if you answer yes, the next day you'll be meeting girls. If you say no, then do you have a girlfriend? Is she from our caste? And all those questions. And these days, this question is getting popular. Do you drive your car on the other side of the street? If you know what I mean.
Oh.
You have to be ready to answer so many questions. As soon as you say yes, they will find out all their contacts and arrange meetings with the people. On an average, every Indian person meets 15 to 30 other people before they get married. If you are lucky, you'll find your partner in the 100th place. This is God's way of telling you, you idiot, run away. But if God wants to kick you in the first place, you are going to find your partner in the first place. If you both like each other and the families like each other, they come to an agreement and then they start the wedding preparations. And there are so many series. There is haldi, there is pre-engagement, there is pre-wedding photo shoot, then booking the plaza and blah, blah, blah. We do have at least 4 to 5 days of wedding. And if you are rich enough, it can last for 2 weeks. Indians spend on an average $30,000 to $65,000 on a wedding. Yes, it has become a huge business and it's a festival because we get to see each other and the prospective grooms and bride can see their partners, future partners in those weddings. I was a little concerned considering all the expense, but after a lot of fight, I gave in. So next time, if you see me with a girl and I call her my wife, don't get surprised. Before I end off my speech, I would like to add a note. Love marriages do happen in India. People, nobody forces you to marry a stranger. So it's all, arranged marriage is a choice for a lot of people. Thank you.